Blackstone Audio presents The Mystery of Providence by John Flavel. This book is read by Jim Denison. Author's Introduction. I will cry unto God Most High, unto God that performeth all things for me. Psalm 57, verse 2. The greatness of God is a glorious and unsearchable mystery. For the Lord Most High is terrible. He is a great king over all the earth. Psalm 47, verse 2. The condescension of the Most High God to men is also a profound mystery. Though the Lord be high, yet he hath respect unto the lowly. Psalm 138, verse 6. But when both these meet together, as they do in this scripture, they make up a matchless mystery. Here we find the Most High God performing all things for a poor, distressed creature. It is the great support and solace of the saints in all the distresses that befall them here, that there is a wise spirit sitting in all the wheels of motion and governing the most eccentric creatures and their most pernicious designs to blessed and happy issues. And indeed, it were not worthwhile to live in a world devoid of God and providence. How deeply we are concerned in this matter will appear by that great instance which Psalm 57 presents us with. It was composed, as the title notes, by David when he hid himself from Saul in the cave. It is inscribed with a double title, Altashkeith Michtam of David. Altashkeith refers to the scope, and Michtam to the dignity of the subject matter. The former signifies, destroy not, or let there be no slaughter, and may either refer to Saul concerning whom he gave charge to his servants not to destroy him, or rather, it has reference to God, to whom, in this great exigency, he poured out his soul in this passionate ejaculation, Altashkeith, destroy not. The latter title, Michtam, signifies a golden ornament, and so is suited to the choice and excellent matter of the psalm, which much more deserves such a title than do Pythagoras's golden verses. Three things are remarkable in the former part of the psalm: his extreme danger, his earnest address to God in that extremity, and the arguments he pleads with God in that address. His extreme danger is expressed in both the title and the body of the psalm. The title tells us this psalm was composed by him when he hid himself from Saul in the cave. This cave was in the wilderness of Engedi, among the broken rocks where the wild goats lived, an obscure and desolate hole. Yet even there, the envy of Saul pursued him. See 1 Samuel chapter 24, verses 1 and 2. And now that he had been so long hunted as a partridge upon the mountains, seems to be enclosed in the net. His enemies were outside the cave, from which there was no other outlet. Then Saul himself entered the mouth of this cave, in the sides and creeks of which David and his men lay hidden, and they actually saw him. Judge to how great an extremity, and to what a desperate state things were now brought. Well might he say, my soul is among lions, and I lie even among them that are set on fire. Verse 4. What hope now remained? What but immediate destruction could be expected? Yet this does not frighten him out of his faith and duty. But between the jaws of death he prays, and earnestly addresses himself to God for mercy. Be merciful unto me, O God, be merciful unto me. Verse 1. This excellent psalm was composed by him when there was enough to discompose the best man in the world. The repetition notes both the extremity of the danger and the ardency of the supplicant. Mercy, mercy, nothing but mercy, and that exerting itself in an extraordinary way can now save him from ruin. The arguments he pleads for obtaining mercy in this distress are very considerable. First, he pleads his reliance upon God as an argument to move mercy. Be merciful unto me, O God, be merciful unto me, for my soul trusteth in thee. Yea, in the shadow of thy wings will I make my refuge, until these calamities be overpassed. Verse 1.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.